Fair City's become one of Europe's major tourist areas. There's plenty of things to see and the nightlife to match. I can vouch for that. Everyone, though, tonight is at Shelbourne Park for the Paddy Power Derby Final. It's going to be a great race if the last three runnings are anything to go by.
Does they come down towards the second half, Ben? But Judicial Prize still remaining. Three lengths clear from Rapid Range, who's trying hard to close. Half these comes Miss Tempe as they come up towards winning line. Judicial Prize going to win by a couple of lengths. Trap two, Judicial Prize. Tiny's Bud, she's trying to repel. Cool performance at the moment. Cool performance. It's got his head in front from Tiny's Bud. Two Jubies Vieri done no favours. They're bunching up off the final, Ben. It's five. Cool performance. Lele Show's finishing on this near side. Oh, it's gone to the photo.
He's five clear as they hit the third bend. Bypass Byway. Droopy's Agassi is second. It's all over. Bypass Byway is on his way to glory. This is a magnificent run. The son of Spire Nikita and Sandy Penny. Up on Michael Kearney. Trained by Annie Bray. He's won the derby.
The Taoiseach Verdi Ahern presented the trophy 12 months ago. The Irish president, Mary McAleese, does the honours this year. A great record-breaking performance by Bypass Byway last year, hoping for a further track record, possibly tonight, in a packed house here for Shelbourne Park. One of seven races coming up live. The Paddy Power Irish Derby Final is the main race coming up at 9:46. You can see behind me, a massive crowd has wedged their way into Shelbourne Park. Not even a sardine could get in here tonight. Here's a look at tonight's Super 7. That feature coming up at 9:46, preceded by a consolation final at 9:26. A decent hurdle race to come as well. Other supporting cards, and no race tonight worth less than €1,000. And the distances in this country are in yards. They have gone European as far as money's concerned, but not quite yet got that far. They're still not having gone to metric distances, though. Here's one non-runner to tell you about on tonight's card in the 9-10 race. Number two, Benny the Drill, is a non-starter. The reserve there, Candy Kisses, runs in that 9-10 race. Usual suspects on the programme tonight. We've got Darrell in the betting ring, Errol's in the commentary box, and Jonathan Hobbs of the Racing Post is with me as well. What a fantastic atmosphere, Hobbsy.
It's great. I think it kind of feels like we've got half of Dublin in here, doesn't it, really? And there was a tremendous roar for the second race, a Paul Hennessy good thing, and really warmed the cockles on a chilly night, anyway.
It's good. A great night's race. It's the best probably Greyhound night racing of the whole year, isn't it?
€150,000 to the winner, of course. Certainly the richest Greyhound race at the moment. A red-hot favourite, Climate Control. And, yeah, I think it's going to be a terrific final. Good supporting card as well.
So we've got the big race betting then, shall we? Climate Control has obviously said favourite. Going to be short, I think. It's been favourite since the competition started. He's 4-6 at the moment. 7-2, Droopy's Joel. Bar the 2 is 9-2, Mustang Mega in Trap 4. We're hearing from that one's trainer later on. 10-1, Maryville Rumble. A couple of outsiders. A Pony La Fontaine, the only British runner left in the competition. And First Charter at 40-1. Climate Control, is he a good thing?
When you think right at the start of the competition, the anti-post, the Greyhounds dominated with Serene Rumble and Climate Control, and all through the shocks has been Droopy's Agassi, Born a Pilot. Climate Control is still standing. Good winner of his semi-final last week, and he's got terrific early pace and tremendous backstraight pace as well. But there are dangers. Droopy's Joel seems to be coming into some terrific form at the moment, and so well backed anti-post. You've also got Mustang Mega, the only bitch in the race as well, and she could spoil things for the Fav. They're cracking out.
I think it should be a real cracker. Let's check out Hobbs' choice then for tonight's seven live Sky races. I just want to throw those quickly, Jonathan.
Quite a few trap fours. The Shelbourne stats tell us that trap four has been the leading trap this year, so no worries about the black jacket. We've gone with Mustang Mega, just really for value terms in the lucky last, the final. Call the Police, heavily backed in the offices today, and I think the step up in trip's going to suit that greyhound. Chief's Order, superb early pace. Opposing Bookie Burglar, I struggle to find one to oppose him. He's a novice hurdler, of course, a good winner of his first hurdles race, but he's got to jump them. And at the price, I think he's ready to oppose. I went with Corliss Cruiser. It's probably the heart as opposed to the head.
OK, let's head off to the betting ring, shall we? Our reporter tonight is Darrell Williams, who squeezed himself in there, Darrell. Good evening to you.
Hello, Dave. Good evening. It's a little bit busy, as you might imagine, here this evening. One or two people have decided to make it to the Irish Derby final, and we have got, plenty going on in the betting ring. So we're looking forward to a very, very good evening. Let me give you some betting on this first race for us here, the 8:06. Trap 1 is 9-2 at the moment. In fact, just gone from 4-1 as I speak. The favourite, though, is Trap 6, Call the Police, at 9-4. Then they're betting 3-1, Trap 3, Kaelin's Charm. It is now 9-2, Trap 1, Belinda Babs. Betting 5-1, Trap 5, Bon Mahone Breeze. 6-1, Trap 4, Droopy's Beckham. And it's 8-1, Trap 2, Lotto Princess. That's betting on the opener, Dave.
There's some massive crowds as you'd expect here. Let's get to the Sky Sports predictor coming up then for our first. Peter Meldrum's got his Irish connection in situ, and he's gone for trap six in the first race, but not far behind is the five runner, around about a half a length separating those two. So he's certainly calling the police, Peter Meldrum.
Heavily back today, bet 3.65, 5-2 into twos, Cashman's 9-4 and a 7-4. Well backed, of course, with Corals and Ladbrokes as well, both into 15-8 from 5-2 and 9-4. Winner of the Thurles Marathon, including a track record run, was beaten last time here over 600 yards, but up to 750 yards, I think the trip's going to suit. You've got a Greyhound running in trap four, Droopy's Beckham, of course, I'm sure is going to be extremely popular amongst almost everyone, I should imagine, making its staying bow, Droopy. Is Beckham, but you'd have to have an early, a fast start for the four. And great to see Lotto Princess running as well for Paul Hennessy. He's had the last winner, the well-backed Jordan's Elect. He's looking for Lotto Princess now. She's getting on in years, but she's a mum. She this year had a litter of pups, so cracking to see her back on track. And she absolutely bolted home at Kilkenny last time. Six for me.
You can see the latest prices on the Sky Sports info bar on the bottom of the screen there. They've just taken the 9-4 about Call the Police back to 2-1 as they start to load up for our first race. The Paddy Power 750. It's a circuit and a half. We're going to head upstairs to the commentary box and say very good evening to Errol Blythe.
Yeah, good evening, Dave. It's a lovely night here at Shelbourne Park. You've already mentioned how busy it is. Where else would you get ticket touts outside a Greyhound Stadium selling the tickets? It's sold out for love nor money. But we're in for a great night's racing. We start off with this six-bend race where they're all in for this race over 750 yards. That's 686 metres, sponsored by Paddy Power. €1,000 to the winner. The hare is on the way. And the favourite, of course, in trap six, Call the Police, showing at 9-4, but a little bit uneasy. There's money for trap three, Kaylin's Charm, on the track back from 7-2 down to 3-1. And I understand that Ladbrokes laid some money as well. They're off and running and racing up towards the first bend. And Bellin to Babs is out in front and gets a flyer from three, Kaylin's Charm in second. After these racing back in third comes Droopy's Beckham as they go round past the second bend and past us here in the stands. And it's one, Bellin to Babs, leading the way here by two lengths over three. Kaylin's Charm is trying to close. After these, you can see trap four moving up closer. Droopy's Beckham, they head down the far side, and Kaylin's Charm goes on. She leads now, being chased by Droopy's Beckham in second. Dropping away is Bellin to Babs. Call the Police, the favourite, struggling back in fifth. They go around the second last bend, and it's Kaylin's Charm out in front. There was money on the track. There's been money in the offices this morning, and Kaylin's Charm's going to make most here. Trap three, Kaylin's Charm the winner. Binning four, Droopy's Beckham in second. Bon Mahone Breeze stayed on best of the rest to take third. So the favourite, Call the Police, was drifting on the track from around 2-1 out to 9-4. There was money for trap three, Kaylin's Charm, this morning in the offices, and also I can tell you here on track, trained by Kevin Losty and owned by Mines a Pint Syndicate from County Kildare. Will there be plenty of pints drowned by those boys tonight here at Shelbourne Park? What a good start from trap one, Bellin to Babs, showing great early pace for trainer Tony Fahey Jr., of course, a greyhound that had been running over four bends recently at Longford and Shelbourne Park here and doing some fair times at Longford. You can see that trap three, though, is right on its tail around the third bend, had to check momentarily. I can tell you that the winner, trap three, Kaylin's Charm, has been returned at 7-2. Here comes trap four, Droopy's Beckham, starting to close. I'm afraid Call the Police, never really at the races, back in fifth place. But as they go around the second last bend, it's Kaylin's Charm leading the way around here. This daughter of Tom's the best out of a white picture going on and staying on powerfully all the way towards the winning line. Plugging on in second was Droopy's Beckham. Back in third, it looks as though trap five, Bon Mahone Breeze. In fact, that's been confirmed by the judge, finishing back in third. And I can tell you the winning time's just come up as well. 42.46 for the winning time here at Shelbourne Park. Let's take a look at the closing stages again. And a trap three, Kaylin's Charm, looking pretty impressive over this kind of distance.
Nice performance there by Kaylin's Charm, returned at 7-2 for trainer Kevin Losty. If you back the six, you may want to call a copper about the six, call the police. Never able to get in a blow at any stage in the race. Just seemed to miss the break and did best work coming home, but could not get up to the first two. We're off for a quick break now. There's a runner from England in our next race in the shape of Farlow Style for Seamus Cahill. It looks an open contest, so the locals should have sway with Spinner's Choice in the red jacket and Chief's Order in trap five. It's over 550 yards the next race, and it's going to be a cracker as well. So don't miss it. Stay with us here live on Sky Sports. Welcome back to Dublin. Fairly good night so far for punters. It's an up and down night for bookmakers as well. So fantastic facilities here at Shelbourne Park as well. And there's the first race winner for us, Kaylin's Charm, owned by Minds of Pint Syndicate. We know where they're off to after this presentation. A good performance by their little girl, Kaylin's Charm, winning well and went off at this SP.
So the full result here at Shelbourne Park on the 8.06, a win for Trap 3, Kaylin's Charm, returned at 7-2. Second place going to Trap 4, Droopy's Beckham, at 6-1. The winning time was 42.46.
Regular viewers know, of course, we have a competition at this point in the programme. Just one look at it tonight. It's an Irish one as well. Free £500 bet on the 9.46, the big race courtesy of Skybet. And here is tonight's poser. Which river runs through the fair city of Dublin? And here are tonight's three options. Is it A, the Clyde, B, the Severn, or C, the Liffey? Here's the number to ring when you know your answer. And don't forget to have your bet ready, which horse or which greyhound do you want your money invested on. Phone number 09015 646161. That's 09015 646161. Or you can text us. If you're going to text us, listen very carefully. This is how you have to do it. You text 85088 with the word greyhound, then your answer, either A, B, or C, what you want your monkey invested on in that 9.46, and also your name. That's text 85088, the word greyhound, the answer A, B, or C, what you want the bet on in the 9.46, your monkey if you win, and your name as well. Bit complicated, but give it a try. It's worth £500 free bet on tonight's big winner. Let's head off then to the betting ring. There's been lots of action today in the offices up and down England and in Ireland. Darrell's got all the news.
And I think, Dave, judging by the results so far, the money is telling the story here tonight. So let's have a look at these hot dogs, which start out in the hurdle race coming up as the 8.38. This is Bookie Burger, they've backed here. Remember, of course, got to the semi-finals of the Derby, but over Timber tonight. 4-6 from 8-11 with Cashman. That's been very well backed. And further down, Kiki's first been backed with Ladbrokes at big prices, 33s into 20s. 8.54 race. Trap 1's been supported here. The good stay of Tina's girl, O'McKenna's runner, with Cashman in particularly, 7-4 in from 2-1. And Owen McKenna's got a couple that they've backed in the 9.26. Droopy's Agassi, that's obviously going to be the favourite. 4-5 with Bet365 from evens. But they've also come in for his other runner here, Chestnut Jet. 10s down to 8s. And finally, in the big one itself, the Irish Derby Final at 9.46. Plenty of money around for Mustang Mega here today. That's been backed from 6s down to 5s. And Dave, we're expecting this favourite to be a bit shorter in this next race here. Chief's Order could well be even money, I'm told, in this 8.22.
Thanks, Darrell. Down on the news then from hot dogs during the day. Interesting one or two market moves there, especially Mustang Mega in the final.
Well, that's right. I think he's got an early pace chance. Victor Chandler were biggest 6-1 about Stephen Burke's bitch. And if she's in front, she's got every chance. I mean, Droopy's Joel picked her up in the semi-finals, but he did get a clear run round bends 1 and 2 in the semis. If he doesn't get as clear a run round, the bitch might have flown. Of course, climate control is going to be on a wide outside. It's not as easy as that. Droopy's Agassi, an interesting move. A little bit unlucky in the semi-finals to crash out. Finalist last year, of course. Really has star quality all about him. Some will say a little bit disappointing last week, but certainly the gaps didn't open when he was making his move. So
he never saw another dog throughout the competition, Droopy's Agassi, until the semi-finals.
Well, that's right. Sometimes that happens. I mean, he's been a little bit of an unlucky greyhound when you think, even in last year's final, he wasn't quite right in the run-up to the final. But hopefully there's some sort of consolation this evening.
Well, here's the greyhounds then on parade for our second race. Let's take a close look at them, shall we? Here's the Trap 1 runner. This is Spinner's Choice, trained by John Donoghue. Excellent chance is Spinner's Choice, I suppose. She's rapidly improving anyway.
Was a terrific run last time, wasn't it? Over 5.25, 28.56. Don't worry about the increased distance. 5.50 yards a trip for this one. Has form over 5.75.
That's the Trap 1 runner, Spinner's Choice. Wearing the blue jacket of Trap 2 is Smooth Midas, trained in the north here by Joe Blair. Quite a capable sort as well, I suppose, really, on the comeback.
Well, Lifton Racegoers certainly would know Smooth Midas, a 28.87, which is a pretty decent run at that particular track. But, of course, always bred to be a decent greyhound. Smooth Rumble, Midas Blossom, of course, a brother to the Gold Collar, Harold's Cross Gold Collar winner of last year, Cabbage White.
currently a 12-1 chance of the two dogs, Smooth Midas. In trap three is Farlow Style, trained at Wimbledon by Seamus Carhill and part owned by him, and the lady Walkham in parade, that's Teresa Lynch, Farlow Style. Impressive winner last time, at least.
Huge British interest in this, of course. So we've got the Select Stakes runner-up, at Derby quarter finalist as well. He's got fantastic early pace, Farlow Style. Desperately unlucky when sent over for the Irish Derby. Was knocked over, literally, at the bend in the first round of the Irish Derby. But has come back and a 10-1 winner last week. Certainly was a few punters in my neck of the woods who missed that last week. Hopefully, he'll go in again for them.
He's currently a 5-1 chance. Wednesday Prince on the boards at 7-1. Wednesday Prince running well at present. Goes up very fast at the bend.
Got a fair sprint time at Mullingar, 21:60 for the sprint there. So it's all about early pace for this greyhound. One out of six before, but don't worry about trap four. For Wednesday Prince has bolted in from four, even at Shelbourne Park as well, 28.97, admittedly a while back.
That's the trap four runner, Wednesday Prince. In trap five is Chief's Order, trained by Seamus Graham, and this runner here is a powerful galloper.
He actually led up when he was knocked out in the second round, knocked out in the second round of the Derby. But actually in the first round, he beat Axel Greece into third place. Now Axel Greece, of course, the Oaks champion. He's a son of Cool Survivor, of course, 1995 Oaks winner, and part owned by good friends of mine, Ian and Michael Fortune.
That's Chiefs for the then, currently at 7-4. The outside runner, Bright Man, in trap six, owned and trained by Cyril Dunn. Missed the start last time it ran, got a nice draw there out wide of the other five.
Yeah, knocked out the second round of the Derby, but actually won the Kilkenny Irish Derby Trial Stakes. Also ran in the Droopy's Kewl event recently here. It knocked out in the semi-finals behind Take a Right. Great draw outside. I think a lot of pace inside for Bright Man to contend with, but if he gets a run, he's a huge chance.
That's the six runners then heading for the traps of the Paddy Power 550. There are 20 bookmakers vying for the punters' Euros here at Shelbourne Park, and they get variation of bets. One bets about best of five, one bets best of four, one even bets best of three. Money for the favourite, I think, Darrell.
Plenty of money for the favourite. You could have had 7-4 a couple of minutes ago with Tech Hegarty and most of the layers alongside him, but it's now down to 5-4. We did say we thought it might go even shorter, so we'll keep an eye on that. 5-2 trap one, Spinner's Choice is pretty steady. Down the bottom, they're going 5-1 trap six, Bright Man, just easing out. 5-1 is Farlow Style. Spoke to Teresa Lynch a few minutes ago, of course, assisted to Seamus Carhill. Thinks the dog will run well again, so might be worth looking at. And then they're betting 7-1 trap four, Wednesday Prince, and 12-1 trap two, Smooth Midas.
Here's a Sky Sports predictor. They favour the red dog here, Spinner's Choice, over the five, Chief's Order. About a half a length again between the two, six further back behind. Spinner's Choice, what was your selection here?
I've gone with five, Chief's Order. I think in pretty decent nick. He's got huge early pace, such a well-bred greyhound, and six wins from 13 starts, a pretty fair record as well. Spinner's Choice, got that lightning time at Enniscorthy, of course, and then won very, very well here last week, 28.56, a flying time, huge early pace, and probably drawn for success as well on the fence. But we've got the likes of Chief's Order running out of trap five, Bright Man in trap six, Farlow Style can trap from time to time, of course, and he could just get away from them. But I think the problem for the three dot is going to be the pace of trap one, Spinner's Choice. By that time, Chief's Order could have flown.
It's fair to say that Chief's Order's got to come out well, otherwise you throw away your ticket.
Well, he runs his better races when he comes out well. I mean, he beat Bright Man at Shelbourne Park back on the 28th of August, a tremendous run on that occasion. So, and he came out running then. I think the longer run to the bend does suit him. It's the 550-yard start, of course. And once in front, well, it could be all over. Of course, talked about the breeding top honcho, Cool Survivor, cracking.
Greyhounds heading for the traps then for the first race. There's a shot of the packed grandstand here. I said earlier when you wouldn't get a sardine in there. I think that's probably true. It's a great advertisement for the sport here in Ireland, who's been, well, it's gone leaps and bounds over the last two or three years, but the crowds really love greyhound racing. You can see what the amount of people here tonight, Jonathan.
And I can tell you there'll be a huge, huge roar if the five goes in. Absolutely punted, extremely heavily. They were very silent, weren't they, when Call the Police, who didn't run particularly well, was well beaten in our previous race. But if this fab goes in, I think the roof's going to come off, even now.
Greyhounds are going in to the traps for our second race. It's Paddy Power 5.50. Chief's Order, you can see on that info bar, is at 5-4. 5-2 for Spinner's Choice in trap one. 4-1 about the three-dog Farlow Style, the English challenger here. 5-1 for the six, Bright Man. And 8-1 trap four, Wednesday Prince, and 14-1 about the two dogs, Smooth Midas. They're very nearly all set. Here's Errol.
Lots of interest, of course, on the English Greyhound Farlow Star. We know him, of course, in the Select Stakes, being just pipped at the winning line by Droopy Shearer. But here at Shelbourne, yes, it won the other week, but it hasn't been coming away as well. If you look at some of the sectional times it's been recording while it's been on these shores. Anyway, the hare on the move then for the 8.22. It's the Paddy Power 5.50. The favourite then in Trap 5, Chief's Order. Spinner's Choice just drifting out to around 11-4 with some of the boards, maybe even bigger. Here we go. 22 boards I counted, by the way, here at Shelbourne Park. They're off and running and racing up towards the first bend. A break here from four. Wednesday Prince along with five. Chief's Order, one rushing up on the inside. Spinner's Choice. A one gets round. There's trouble for Chief's Order to head down the far side. A bit of a roar's gone up beside me as one. Spinner's Choice now goes on. It's five lengths clear from two. Smooth Midas in second. After these come three. Farlow Style. They go round the third bend. It's Spinner's Choice out in front. Leading here by two lengths over two. Smooth Midas is trying to close and making some impression. One's up and down the spot. Two go on. Smooth Midas wins, staying on for second, Bright Man, and back in third was Spinner's Choice. Well, Spinner's Choice falling in a hole basically off the final bend. Success going to Smooth Midas. That's one for the bookmakers. Was drifting all the time on the boards around the 12-1 mark, might be bigger on the SP. Trained by Joe Blair and owned by Mr. Peter Reynolds. All the action here took place at the first bend. You can see that Trap 5, Chief's Order, had a real rough ride around the bend. Stumbled badly itself. Wednesday Prince kept it quite wide. One Spinner's Choice out in front at this stage. They went down towards the third bend. You can see six Bright Man handy. But the eventual winner, Smooth Midas, picks up ground here at the third bend. I can tell it's been returned at 14-1. Rode a bump as well at the third bend from Farlow Style, who tried to nip through on its inside. So they come up towards winner line. It's Spinner's Choice, but closing all the time, Smooth Midas. And it goes past Spinner's Choice, who runs out of puff closing stages. A greyhound that's well experienced, of course, Smooth Midas. He's had 19 starts, winning six of them. And some of those victories have taken place at Lifford. Here's Shelbourne Park, Harold's Cross, Dungannon. So it's been about a bit and stayed on really powerfully up towards the winning line. Spotlight camera on a Trap 3 Farlow Style. And I mentioned it hasn't been trapping here. It's last away Farlow Style. Not the greyhound that we've seen, of course, going into the first bend that we've seen before. Farlow Style forced to check here at the first bend. You can see the trouble on the outside also for Chief's Order, the favourite, carted out wide off that second bend.
Nice performance then by the winner, Smooth Midas, who travelled down from the north with Joe Blair to have a good winning performance here of 14-1. If you back the five-dog Chief's Order, mugged by the four Wednesday Prince of the incident at the first bend. Return 14-1, Smooth Midas. Not a lot of cheers from the punters regarding that race. Hurdle race, though, coming up next. Bookie Burglar eliminated from the semi-final stage of the Derby. He's going to go, instead of the consolation in the 9.26, for a hurdling race as well. One on his debut only on Tuesday of this week. And connections must be pretty confident to give up a chance of winning €5,000 in the consolation to go for just €1,000 in the hurdle race. He's up next. Welcome back to Shelbourne Park, the restaurant here. It's been fully booked for about the last 4 months for tonight. It's packed out in there as well. They're enjoying a great night's greyhound racing and a superb meal as well. You can actually dine here al fresco certain times of the year. That canopy at the back there rolls away. You can eat out in the open. They've seen a great success in their previous race as well for Smooth Midas, who came home pretty smoothly down the straight to take the honours at a fairly large prize. Bookmaker race, I think you can probably say, the race on the card. It came home quite well. Let's check those SPs and Errol's got them.
So the full result on the 8.22 here, the Paddy Power 5.50, won by Trap 2, Smooth Midas, returned at 14-1. Second place, Trap 6, Bright Man at 5-1. Just to say that the winning time here was 30.04.
First flyer of the night, then after our 8.22 race, 14-1 the price of Smooth Midas, £15 then going on the next leg. Hopefully you might get six winners in a row tonight and get up tonight's Sky Fly. It could be a nice dividend come 9.46. A nice success for Smooth Midas. Connections have joined Darrell.
Thanks very much indeed, Dave. A bit of a surprise, well, to most of us, punting. I'm not sure whether it's a surprise to the trainer, Joe Blair.
It wasn't a surprise because I wanted him back for the Derby and he didn't send him in time. He got an injury in the Wimbledon, in the English Derby. So we thought they would get it started out, but they didn't get it started in time, so we sent them back.
He's run a good race, hasn't he, for you?
Yeah, he ran a great race.
You're based in Northern Ireland, so whereabouts have you come down from?
From outside Larne, the North Coast, you may say. We're really, it's 120-odd miles, and we do it two or three times a week, usually.
OK, Joe, now I think just appearing away to the side, hopefully I can have a quick word with a couple of your owners, or your owners. Peter Reynolds is one of them. Peter's next to me here. I think his other owners just wandered off, Colin Oxen. Peter, you've come over from England, like many of us have. This has made the journey more than worthwhile, hasn't it?
Oh, it's brilliant, yeah. Brilliant. It's made up for the trainers and everything. I mean, she's done a brilliant job with the dogs, Joey. Brilliant job.
So why have you got a dog running in Ireland, then? What's the story there?
I mean, the race money in England's rubbish. Race money in Ireland's brilliant.
What have you just won?
€1,000. In England, you've been £100. In an open race, here you win £1,000.
Your trainer was, you know, he was adamant the dog was going to run well at a big price. Were you as confident?
I mean, Joey said the dog needed a run. No, like, so, you know, he was awful, like, but, like, said the dog needed a run, it'll come on for a run.
And what about the atmosphere here, Irish Derby night? It's just something else, isn't it?
Come here every year, it's brilliant. Brilliant. They're all going to go up after in the final of the Derby.
Hey, listen, good to see you with a winner.
Thanks very much.
Enjoy the rest of the night. Thanks very much.
Bye. Thanks, Derry. It's interesting that the owner was saying that the prize money is rubbish in England, it's much better over here. And the prize money is better over here, I must admit. I mean,
well, that's right. He should come over to England. But I mean, most of the prizes, the big prizes, you know, there's plenty of sponsorship money, of course, and some pretty decent prizes that we had in England. But generally, if you compare the low grades, and you know, there's no comparison. The Irish is far greater. But a lot of the Sky races, which were important, you know. £500 and £1,000, aren't they, sir?
Paddy Power Irish Derby is €150,000, whereas the English William Hill Derby is £100,000. £100,000 to the winner in England. Here, €150,000 is about £107,000-£108,000. But there are other deductions to be made before the actual winner gets the cheque.
Well, that's right. I mean, there's some money goes to the, not just trainer, the trainer, but the breeder as well. I mean, they try to encourage the breeding over here. And I think it's a great way to do it. And, of course, the owner perhaps goes away with a little bit less, but nevertheless, it's still a pretty decent prize. So I think it's something that you know, maybe we should look at. There certainly should be a breeder's prize to encourage British breeding.
Yeah, so it's a great influx of money that's coming to Greyhound Racing, not only in Ireland, especially in Ireland, but also in England as well. Prize money's creeping up a little bit, but not as much as owners would like.
Yeah, I think they're battling all the way. I mean, we've got the GRA situation, of course, up at Bellevue, of course, and you know, the threats of owners going to take their dogs out on strike and what have you. That's up to them. If they feel that they're hard done by, then go for it. But, I mean, Ireland, of course, has been a terrific lead, really, I think, for England. And they are working together now, the British Greyhound Racing Board, the Irish Greyhound Board. And hopefully that will, just increase sponsorship, increase further investment in it. I mean, if you go around the tracks in Ireland, some of the investments, I mean, incredible, really.
Well,
I mean, not least Shelbourne Park and not least Harold's Cross.
Lifford as well,
exactly right.
Fantastic amount of money being spent by Bordnacon and things, the Irish Greyhound Board, for that sort of thing. But obviously it's such European money, I'd imagine, is where it's come from. It's been in a common market.
Well, if you think that over in our country, of course, the GRA have just put Perry Bar, and there's going to be some investment there, of course. So, yeah, I mean, Coventry is just about to open,
we hope.
They're talking about Edinburgh track reopening as well, so.
Let's hope so. Let's go and look for the runners end on the parade for our next race on the card, shall we? And they're in trap one for this race. Loves a Rails and an ideal draw, Honcho Jewel.
He actually reached the final of the Baggett Racing Irish Grand National stake at Newbridge, of course, and ran behind Katunda Galileo, who reopposes in trap two. Nothing really between these two. In fact, there was just a neck when they last met between them. And then Honcho Jewel, prior to that in the heats, won by 3.5 lengths after getting a fast start and making the most of trap one. If he does that once again, he could just sneak a lead on the inner.
That's Honcho Jewel at 5-1. Two is Katundo Galileo, trained by Tom Lynch, currently at 7-1. Got good early speed, this runner.
Well, definitely, and as I say, very closely matched with the Honcho Jewel Greyhound. Katundo Galileo's of huge interest, really, for Sheffield punters, of course. Came over for a spell over at Sheffield, won a number of sprints. Now, that tells us he's got good early pace, Katundo Galileo, and looked to stamp his authority on this pretty early in the race. But, hey,
we've got a phenomenally fast greyhound in trap three to go with.
Let's have a look at him, Shelby. This is Bookie Burglar, currently a 2-1 on chance. Knocked out of the semis of the Greyhound Derby, almost only jumping a flight.
What a massive story this would be as well. Bookie Burglar, semi-finalist in the Irish Derby, but Stuart Kenny, the part owner of Paul Hennessy's greyhound, decided he wanted to go hurdling with it. They do pop this greyhound over hurdles at Hennessy's range. He's had one hurdles race at Thurles. He won by four lengths, but he took a tumble after the line. He's still in that learning curve as regards hurdle racing, but he's already been under the track record at Kilkenny in a trial. Smashed it.
In trap four is Cornish Cruiser. Tommy Foster trained at Wimbledon, but has now been brought over here to join John Donoghue, along with three others of Tommy's inmates, to contest the Irish Grand National. He's currently a 6-1 chance.
Which is what Cornish did last year, of course, and he reached the final of the Irish Grand National at Harold's Cross. He's a tough, consistent greyhound. I have to say that if this was a year ago, he was a year younger, I think he would have a massive chance against Bookie Burglar, because I think he's certainly the most accomplished jumper of these six. We've got a novice in trap three, we've got a novice in trap five as well. Is he quick enough?
Yeah, I should say Corliss is the only one that's joined John O'Donoghue. Tommy's bringing the other three runners over. Here's Five Kiki's first, a newcomer to jumping hurdles.
Having his first hurdles race this evening is Kiki's first. Just had the four trials. He's got form over six bends on the flat, this greyhound, but he's only had four races as well, the one win and the one second, and just those four hurdles trials. Remains to be seen how, in the thick of the action, he'll cope with it. I have to say, there has been money for him from Ladbrokes today, 33s into 20s or so, but speculative, I would say.
10-1 is its price then for the five-dog Kiki's first. In trap six is Connery Express. Won over hurdles at Limerick back in August, but looks a bit more tricky in this company.
Well, he won at Limerick 29.87. If you can compare that to the track record of 29.18, I think he's got a little bit to find with some of these. But he was a good winner on the flat over 5.75 here, so no worries about the trip. We'll be running on, and he did compete in a Newbridge competition last time behind Honcho Jewel. Of course, well beaten behind Honcho Jewel, 15.5 lengths, it has to be said. So it'll be a massive surprise if six reverses form with one.
Greyhound's done no far to get to the starting traps. It's just in the home straight here. Let's check out the betting price. What price is Bookie Burglar?
Well, it's been well back to Dave, I have to say. You could have had 4-7 initially, but 4-9 generally looking along the boards here for trap three Bookie Burglar. They're betting behind that. They go 6-1 trap one Honcho Jewel. It is also 6-1 trap four Cornish Cruiser. 8-1 2 Katunda Galileo. It's generally tens, although it's just beginning to ease out trap five Kiki's first, but tens generally, a bit of 12s around. And 14s trap six Connery Express.
Bookie Burglar on the Sky Sports predictor is a long, long way in advance of Cornish Cruiser, comes out second best on the figures. Is it a case of come out Bookie Burglar and draw the money?
If he jumps, I think he wins, and he'll probably win quite comfortably. I mean, he took, I think it was 39 spots off of Deb's the best, his track record, only in a trial, of course.
They're all set then. Last one's coming forward. There's the first flight of hurdles they'll be facing, called by Errol Blythe.
Yes, and they jump four flights of hurdles altogether. Hare on the move then, and it's still about 4-9 at the moment. Bookie Burglar, limited experience over flights, but a good winner recently at Thurles, reached the semis of the Irish Derby, so it's the class act on the flat. Here it comes, they're off, and running up towards the first bend, and six, Connery Express is away fast here, showing the early pace, and three, Bookie Burglar, checked badly going into that first flight, and it must have gone lame, heading down the far side, and it's six, Connery Express out in front, four, Cornish Cruiser off in chase, as they head down the far side towards the final flight there, and it's six, Connery Express leading from Cornish Cruiser's trying to pick it up, Bookie Burglar's now racing, but a long, long way behind the whole host of runners, and it's six, Connery Express, still with a length lead, Cornish Cruiser's closing all the time, and it's Connery Express who wins it. Trap six, Connery Express causes another major shock here. Second place going to trap four, Cornish Cruiser. But the big incident here is what happened to Bookie Burglar at the start. All of a sudden it seemed to check when it saw the first flight. I thought it had gone lame, but certainly afterwards it was running. It was all over the place, wasn't it? Heading towards that first flight. Tail was whipping round, not quite sure what was going on there. Down the far side, it seemed to be running on okay. But you can see that Connery Express has taken up an early lead here. 14-1 outsider. It's trained by Oliver Lott and owned by the Connery Syndicate at County Wicklow and has won at 20-1, so shock after shock so far tonight. But as you can see, Cornish Cruiser, the English Greyhound, closing all the time for Tommy Foster. But in the end, Connery Express finds a bit more. I recognise the breeding of this one. Take time out of last line. I had a greyhound called Red Mick once, many, many moons ago. It's by Moramich, who was the dam of last line. And Moramich, of course, won a Pall Mall. Anyway, let's concentrate on the action here. Jumping the final flight, Connery Express here has caused a major surprise. Cornish Cruiser closing all the time, but goes down by about 3/4 of a length inside the closing stages. Now, we had our spotlight camera on Bookie Burglar. Let's find out if we can see what happened. It's okay now, but all of a sudden it's cramped up. I'm not quite sure what it is, but it's bad, bad, bad sign there at the start. But all of a sudden you'll see that it starts to run. You'll start seeing it flow a bit better now going down the far side, but it seemed as though it's checking there at that hurdle as well. Wasn't quite sure what to make of that flight. Let's just watch it here. It's all by itself. It's not jumping brilliantly either, Bookie Burglar. But at the start, it was real dramatic scenes. The odds on Jolly, who had been backed from something like 4-7 to 4-9 on the boards, looked as though it tightened up badly going up towards the first flight.
Yeah, it did look like he cramped up there, Jonathan, didn't he, Bookie Burglar? I mean, they take nothing away from the winner, though, Connery Express 20-1, but Bookie Burglar's going to be all the talk of the night, I would think.
I've never seen anything like that, really. I mean, we know what happened at Thurley's. He took a tumble after the line, suggesting that he cramped and then took the tumble. If he'd completed a circuit and the action went like that, you would suggest...
You run yourself out of it, don't you, after a while?
Exactly, you would suggest that might have been cramped, but to come out and the traps, he was okay for one or two strides.
Look at it again, see what you think of it as it came away from the traps. It just seemed to lose its action as though it may well have cramped up in the early.
He came out flying, okay, he's into his paces.
He's just feeling a leg there, isn't
he? He just goes, he just feels something there, and you just presume that he's going to, well, jump the first flight. But then he seemed to finish sound enough, but there's clearly something amiss with Bookie Burglar. I mean, he walked past us and appeared, you know, perfectly sound, but, I mean, in his paces. It wasn't until about the third or fourth bend that he was stretching out and everything seemed to be okay. But, I mean, certainly a huge post-mortem, really, I think, for Bookie Burglar.
Major surprise. I mean, certainly
a huge
big
surprise, really.
Point,
I mean, we knew he got the pace in between the sticks. He was a novice. No problem there. But extraordinary, really. And it's certainly well-backed and the crowd here absolutely
crying. Regretting, I suppose, not going for the consolation. Jumping the hurdles got nothing to do with that.
Well, I think on that performance he would have struggled, of course, to win that. But very, very strange. And there's been a huge amount of money for Bookie Burglar as well. There was that slight disappointment after the line at Thurley's, but he seemed to win well there. And you thought even if he fiddled one or two hurdles, he probably still got the pace to win. I have to say, even subsequently, his jumping wasn't particularly good, but then you wouldn't expect that. But Cornish ran an absolute stormer, didn't
absolute
he?
Absolute cracker, didn't he?
Shock winner.
Connery Express, though, nothing away from that. Brilliant win for him as well. Here's his SP.
So the full result then on our 8:38 contest here at Shelbourne Park, the Paddy Power Hurley Hurdle. A win here for Trap 6, Connery Express, returned at 20-1. And the second there, Trap 4, Cornish Cruiser, went off at 6-1. The winning time, 29.62. And the Sky Flyer, let's add on Connery Express. Well, already to a £1 stake, £315 running onto the third leg, the 8.54.
If you're new to greyhound racing or you'd like to find out more about greyhounds and breeding in particular, there's a forum on tomorrow morning at Harlow Stadium. It takes place at midday. There'll be loads of greyhounds to look at as well and a lot of breeding to look about. It's a breeders' festival and more than 200 greyhounds in several different classes showcasing the best of British breeding, plus a parade of stud dogs as well featuring all that. That breeders' festival tomorrow at 12 noon at Harlow Stadium.
Yeah, a couple of Australian stud dogs in the picture. That's Vinnie Jones' phone, I have to say, behind us.
It's my bookie.
Of course, it's an annual the annual Breeders' Festival, and all that's great about British breeding, they'll be there at Harlow, and they have a fantastic morning. Get along if you can. Tremendous. There's show classes for you know, from puppies to brood bitches. Stud dog parade as well, and great fun for the purists.
good day. It should be a good day. You've heard his phone. Now let's meet the man again. Vinnie Jones. Can you spare us a minute, Vinnie?
Nice to see you again.
Cheers, Dave. How are you?
It's a great night here, isn't it? Well, you love the dogs here and at Wimbledon as well. Fantastic atmosphere here.
Yeah, it's a great atmosphere. Yeah, I was... I had the crack at the English Derby. I went with the lads just before the first bend, and that was good. That's good fun. But no, it's great coming over. You know, have a night out and then shoot back tomorrow.
So is this better than Wimbledon or not, atmosphere-wise? Or
yeah, it is this side. I mean, it's a little bit like Wimbledon, whereas, you know, I'd rather see it at a smaller venue where it's, you know, a lot more noise than that. But definitely on that side, you know, it's buzzing up there. We're up in the Paddy Power box, and... They're just revving up now.
I was going to say, when they back a winner, I think the roof is going to come off, but they're struggling at the moment. I mean, shocks are plenty. I mean, incredible. You were here a couple of years ago, weren't you, for the cool performance beating the Late Late Show. I mean, that was fantastic.
Yeah. That was my nap of the night, obviously, if you remember.
Well, cool performance was, exactly. Yeah. So we got, that was Sean Burke. We got his son, Stephen, in the final. I'm tipping Mustang Mega, crossing my fingers. Are you a fan of climate control?
Well, no, I'm going to go for the two.
The two, which is Drew Joel, yeah.
Yeah.
Been pretty well punted, 66-1, I think a few of the lads have got.
So. Well, me and my mate Pat Curtin, we backed Drupal Jewett in the English Derby, so we ended up with 16-1 on that. We had it each way, so.
You're still involved in ownership, Vinny, and I don't see them. You're still involved in ownership.
But I've been doing a lot of breeding. I've just bred Countrywide Tams with Top Honcho. Mm. Been waiting for that for a while. The barrels, smoking barrels, second letter from her. So really, yeah, I've gone a bit quiet. On the breeding side, really, but you know, so hard to get good dogs now. You know, people want 20, 25 grand for them. You know, I don't think that's, you know, the real side of it. I think, you know, like, you can still pick up nice dogs for 3 and 4 grand, you know.
I suppose you're going to spend 90 days in the country now, can't you?
Well, I'm not there yet, though. I'm not with you yet, mate. No, but I try and I do. I haven't been at Walthamstow, as we said earlier. I haven't been at Walthamstow for a while. I went 2 Thursdays ago, but it's so hard with the filming, you know. But I do try and wangle it so that I can get back for the two derbies, you know. So
where have you been working?
I've been over in Canada. I've been Prague, and I'm going back to South Africa, and you know. So it's really sort of taking off for me in a nice way, you know. But there's no ground racing anywhere.
No.
You know, it's very hard, you know. Like Florida, but in Florida, but I haven't been down there, you know, so...
Well, we had the meme machine all about the football team.
Someone's called a dog after the meme. I see a dog running, I think it was last night somewhere.
Have they paid you for that?
No.
What about the football? Wimbledon moving to Milton Keynes?
Yeah, you know, I just think it's another nail in the coffin, you know. I mean, they had to move, without a shadow of a doubt, you know, but... you know, it's a sad old story. And really, when we were playing, the lads that played, we knew that if we did get relegated, that would be the big slippery slope, and I think that was a big, you know, a big carrot dangling in front of us, that we, you know, we had to stay up with the big boys, and that's why, you know, we were 100% effort every week, you know, but the lads that are there now, you know, it's an hard task for them, you know.
It's a kick in the teeth for the fans, though, when you think about it, isn't it, really?
Yeah, well, a lot of them have gone to the other side, you know, they've gone to
AFC
Wimbledon, you know. But, you know, fair play to them. You know, I think they bought the ground or something, or, you know, they sort of run it themselves. But it's, you know, it's a sad thing, especially what Wimbledon done to get there, you know. And then Sam went, Joe went, Wisey went, I went, Fash went. And you could sort of see the writing on the wall, really.
You know. I went to the cinema the other night to see a film, and you come up with a picture in an advert.
That was Bacardi, a Bacardi one, yeah?
Bacardi, yeah. That's going to be my new... I've got a lovely little pup over in Wexford, where a trainer called Tom Codd, and... That might be my new one. So we'll wait, and we're going to call that smoking rum. So we got the old Bacardi advert.
We got plenty of Vinnie Jones' own pups on the ground, but not so much at racing age at the moment.
Got some nice coursing dogs as well this year.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. Good. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So very much involved. But, you know, you can't have two in the derby every year, obviously. You know.
Well, exactly right. That was great, wasn't it?
Great fun, and you still remember them. Them days, you know, we've just done our new house and done the sports room out, and you get all the stuff out, you know, of what, you know, sort of what's been achieved with the greyhounds.
The smoking bullet.
Yeah, the bullet, and Countrywide Tams, and, you know, the great fun, and then, you know, you put them all up there. Was in the final with another little dog, Catbird, with a collar, you know, so I've had some good fun, so I'm just sort of regrouping again now and going to go again.
Well, thanks for your time, Vinnie. We'll have a drink afterwards, as long as you're buying.
Pleasure. I'll put a couple of
euros. Vinnie, thanks very much.
Cheers, Vinnie.
Right, the Greyhounds out on parade. We'll join those shortly, but massive crowds, as you would expect, here at Greyhound Derby final night here in Ireland. Plenty of money changing hands. So far, it's been a bookmaker's race. Not quite sure about this race, though. Guess some early moves from Darrell.
Thanks very much, Dave. Been a flurry of activity here on track one. Tina's Girl, that's fluctuating between 5-4 and evens. They came in for Tina's Girl a few moments ago. Elsewhere, they're betting 2-1 about track four, Bin's Image. Then 5-1, track three, Tom's Mixture. Elsewhere, it is 6-1. Just easing to sevens now. Track seven booming along. It's 10-1, track two, Black Shiraz. 10-1, track five, Last Attempt.
Early look at the predictor then for this 8.54 race. Well, Tina's Girl does come out best for Owen McKenna. 116 is what Peter Meldrum rates it, 101 for the six dog booming along. So that's round about two lengths in advance of the six dog who thinks Tina's Girl's going to finish. What do you think?
Well, I think it's a tough race. I think you've got Bin's Image in trap four, you've got Tina's Girl in trap one. I mean, she's been in record-breaking form, Tina's Girl, track records at Ewell and Limerick. And there she is.
And there is, yeah. She's a top-class dog, and she's got an ideal draw. He loves her rails.
We're talking about those track records at Ewell and Limerick. If my stats are right, she was something like 30 spots inside the previous mark. She's in outstanding form. She's trained by Owen McKenna, of course, Christine Doherty. Owen trained Droopy's Agassi in the Consolation a little bit later.
Top-class staying bitch, then, is the red dog, Tina's Girl. Here's the two, Black Shiraz, led for much of the journey this distance as well. They've had a couple of runs back.
They're trained by Alison Coxon, part-owned by Alison and Sean Burke, of course, as well, have got interest in the final. She's been in a pretty decent form at the moment. Tully Buck, Last Flight, the breeding, of course, Last Flight, and ex-Nick Savick trained greyhound. Great form at Clonmel. She actually won a novice 750 event at Clonmel, so not too much experience over the longer trip.
12-1's her price, Black Shiraz. In three is Tom's Mixture, trained by Liam O'Callaghan. Now, he'd need to be on his toes in this draw, I'd have thought.
I think Tom's Mixture will have to be. Reached the Derby third round. Of course, that was over the 550. This is 750, so stepping back up in trip. But has got wins at Cork and Harold's Cross over the trip as well. Beat a couple of decent greyhounds by the name of Group Venture and Moving Customer.
That's a three-dog Tom's Mixture at 4-1. 5-2 is the price about four Bin's Image at the moment. And Bin's Image here is a very good stayer. Goes up pretty fast sometimes as well.
Definitely. Kevin Lostey trains this greyhound. He's already had a winner on the card as well, of course. And this is a dog I think really does deserve a big race win. It was in the Corn Cucullin at Harold's Cross in the final. Would have been odds-on favourite. Pulled out because of a virus. Strong running. Fast enough to do 28.66 over four bends at Newbridge.
In trap five, his Last Attempt, trained by Par Campion. Big ask, it's a 12-1 chance, needs a lot of luck in running.
Might be familiar to a few of the Hove punters' Last Attempt. Used to be trained by Brian Clemenson down in Sussex. The last ran around the time of the Regency. We've got graded wins over four and six bends as well. Last Attempt, up against it.
That's the trap five runner, Last Attempt, to complete the field in trap six. He's booming along, trained by Paul Hennessy. He's currently a 7-1 chance, but not a no-hoper.
Not at all. Used to be known as an automatic runner, this greyhound, and won the Cashman's Open 750 at Ewell in, I believe, a fastest time of the year on that occasion, automatic runner. Now known as Booming Along, of course, trained by Paul Hennessy, owned by Mr. Keith Doherty and Mr. Farrington in Dublin.
Let's get off then to the betting ring. Any changes, Darrell?
Dave, you can generally get even money still Tina's Girl, although Ted Heggart has just gone to 4-5, and I think a few of the others are about to join him, but there is even still available. They're betting then 3-1 trap four Bin's Image. It is 4-1 three Tom's Mixture, 7-1 6 booming along. The other two at about 12-1 still. Black Shiraz 12-1, and also trap five Last Attempt 12s. But the evens is going quick here about the favourite.
Greyhound's heading off to the traps end. Bin's Image, your choice here. Hobbs, he's drifting out in the market.
Well, I have to say, it was a toss of a coin between Tina's Girl and Bin's Image. I just kind of fancy that trap four with that 28.66 at Newbridge over the four bends up to 7.50. Last time over 7.50, absolutely bolted in the Harold's Cross in a fair time as well. Talking of times, Tina's Girl has been in a record-breaking form, but she has got a little bit of pace outside. Black Shiraz might just worry her out of it early on. I think if she gets a clear Tina's Girl, she'll win. But Bin's Image might have just flown by that stage.
Runners then loading up on the far side of the track here for this 7.50 Paddy Power. Put her in pretty quick here. Let's get to Errol.
Their last few going in. Tina's Girl, the one that the punters are going for. We've had a couple of shocks, but perhaps this one will help them on their merry way for the big final, of course, coming up in about an hour's time. We're on to the Paddy Power 750, back over the far side, 686 metres the distance, and Tina's Girl now definitely odds on with the boards. Even the boards in front of me now showing odds on after being 11-10. Here we go then, Tina's Girl in one, the warm favourite, trained by Owen McKenna. And they're off and running up towards the first bend. Good break from three. Tom's Mixture leads up early here from four on its shoulder. Bin's Image, a regular round here. After these comes one, Tina's Girl against the rails. After these comes six, booming along. Towards the rear, running very wide was Last Attempt, and outpaced is two, Black Shiraz. They go past the stands, a circuit to go, and three, building on the lead all the time. It's Tom's Mixture leading the way round here from four. Bin's Image in second. Tina's Girl having a few problems on the inside, making no progress. They come down towards the second last bend. It's Tom's Mixture out in front and leading here by three lengths now. Some impression from Bin's Image, only a length and a half between them. Tina's Girl's also trying to stay on. They come around the final bend. Tom's Mixture taken on by on the near side four. Bin's Image is getting up and going away. Bin's Image wins, running on late for second, Tina's Girl, and fading back in third, Tom's Mixture. So a win for trap four, Bin's Image, trained by Kevin Lostie, of course, trained an earlier winner this evening here, owned by John Lostie from County Meath. And landing the spoils here from Tina's Girl, who took an awful long time to get going. You can see two, Black Shiraz, very slowly away. Five, Last Attempt, very wide here at the turn. In fact, forced to check a little bit there at the first bend and went even wider off the second. Meantime, the pace to the race being set by Tom's Mixture, and there must have been a few people scratching their head down the far side because it didn't look as though he was going to come back to the field. He was out in front and he'd built up a 3.5-length lead down the far side over Bin's Image in second. I can tell you that Bin's Image has been returned at 3-1 here. But you can see that Bin's Image coming into the second last bend was just beginning to pick up a bit of pace here inside the last few metres of this race. Coming off the final bend, moved to the outside to challenge Tom's Mixture, who could find no more up towards the winning line. And after these, Tina's Girl, it always there or thereabouts, but never really threatened. And it took her certainly a long time to get going. She just moves up into second place, close home. So, trap four, Bin's Image winning from trap one, Tina's Girl. And back in third, trap three, Tom's Mixture.
Nice performance then by Bin's Image, getting back to winning form, returned at 3-1, Bin's Image. And that was the Hobbsy nap, and he hasn't stopped talking about it since Bin's Image crossed the line. A nice nap for Jonathan at 3-1. Four races gone so far, another three to come, including the big one up at 9:46. So don't go too far away from your TV. You're in for a real cracking last hour of the programme. And it should be a real buzzing one as well, with lots of action to come. Been a mixed day for bookmakers and punters as well. One or two have gone their way. Majority, though, probably have gone the bookmakers' way so far. We're off to another break then. Join us shortly afterwards. We've got more action to come here from Dublin. Three more live ones to come. Welcome back to Dublin. Bin's Image was a very good winner of our seventh race on tonight's card, the 9:10, the Paddy Power 5. Sorry, I should have said the previous race, the Paddy Power 750. Won it really well, Bin's Image, for the lasties, and good success as well. We need to check out the SPs. Let's get there. We've got all the details.
So the result here at Shelbourne Park, a win for trap four. Bin's Image returned at 3-1. And second place, trap one, Tina's Girl, the 4-5 favourite. The second winner of the night, of course, for trainer Kevin Lostie. And a winning time, 42.07, significantly quicker than the other race over 750 yards here. The Sky Flyer, Bin's Image, a 3-1 winner. That means already it's up to £1,260 running onto the fourth leg, the 9:10. It's going to be a massive total.
Let's start a build-up now then, shall we, to tonight's big final of the Paddy Power Irish Greyhound Derby by meeting the finalists.
It's number three, Mustang Mega. Here comes Droopy's Joel with his challenge. In third is number five, Bookie Burglar. Off the final bend into the line, and Wood is challenging, and Droopy's Joel gets up short in the line to win it from Mustang Mega, with four, La Fontaine, getting through in third. A
around the final couple of corners, though it's Droopy Joel that leads. Number six, Drums of College and Chase. Then comes number five, Born a Pilot, but around the final corner, Droopy Joel is not going to be caught. A highly impressive winner of this final heat. Number four, First Charter, goes on again by a length. Serene Rumble not going away, however. Expect a power-packed finish from him. And third, number one, Special Trick, around the final corner of First Charter. But here comes Serene Rumble, powering clear up the home straight. He wins it in style.
Mustang Mega from three, First Charter. Four, Top General. In behind number two, La Fontaine making ground. And Top General is pulling up. He's injured. Off the final bend. It's Mustang Mega out front. Going to win this one comfortably. Off the final bend, and Born a Pilot checks there. Out front, it's Climate Control up front from two, First Charter in second. Five, Maryville Rumble is next. Coming to the line, Climate Control takes it. It's close for second between First Charter and Maryville Rumble. Onto the third bend, and it's still Maryville Rumble out front. And badly balked, number three, Dita Davy. Still Kalahara Dream second. Nikita Billy running on in third. But out front, it's number four. That's Maryville Rumble. Gains it all the way. Victory here.
There they run us in for tonight's big final, coming up live here on Sky Sports at 9.46. Looks to be a real cracker as well. Climate Control is going to be an odds-on favourite. Stat, though, says an odds-on favourite hasn't won this race for 30 years.
Hasn't got a tremendous record, has it? But nevertheless, Climate Control doesn't know that, does he?
You know, good point.
His performances in this competition have been pretty good. That's why he's going to start favourite. And he's, of course, the one to beat.
That's all to come up in round about 40 minutes' time or so, but we've got a couple of races to come before that. Here's the first of them, in which one is Bullets Bill here, trained by Pat Buckley in this contest. Got a nice position on the rails. A perfect draw for
him. Well, he's not often in red Bullets Bill, so it remains to be seen how he's going to cope with it. I would suggest that there's every chance he's going to move off in the dash to the first bend and could just help him because he could be able to hold his position. He's a 28.67, 28.79 greyhound round here, which is pretty decent.
That's a trap one runner, Bullets Bill. Who's a reserve? Candy Kisses from Sean Dooley's Kennels runs now in trap two, does Candy Kisses. And this one's got fairly good form figures.
Has been in tip-top form at the moment, of course. Shelbourne Park wins sub 29 seconds all the way. He's got seemed to have terrific early pace as well, looking for a fast start. I think he might need it with the one probably bearing right out of the boxes.
That's the trap two runner, then the reserve, Candy Kisses. In trap three is Shantabar, trained and owned by Larry Clancy. Shantabar's chances, I suppose, depend on how it comes away.
Likes to dominate his races, and I think he's got to come away pretty well because he's got the reserve in trap two, lightning early, Bullets Bill pretty quick as well. But this is a greyhound who set a trap record at Newbridge in the semi-finals, or the heats of the Texicloth Puppy Derby at Newbridge. Beaten in the final, but only by half a length.
In trap four is Droopy's Rude, trained by Ian Riley. Was mighty impressive last week.
Very, very impressive. 28.57, of course, lightning for the 5.25. He actually reached the Pacific Mile National Puppy Stake final at the back end of last year, behind the likes of Knock Even Major and King's Cadet, of course, and in 2002 won the Munster Puppy Cup.
That's a trap four runner, Droopy's Rude. In trap five is Drumner's College, trained by Pauline Quinn. And this fella can really do it both ways. He can come up or he can come behind.
Well, proving a decent servant for Connection. 22 races, 8 wins and 6 seconds. And that includes victory in a €2,000 550-yard event. Lifford at their opening, or certainly official launch meeting, a week or so ago. Reached the quarterfinals of the Irish Derby, did Drumner College. So no Shelbourne Park extremely well.
3-1 its current price, and the 5-dog Drumner's College. In trap six is Clash Duff Fun, trained by Ollie Bray, produce winner.
No, that's
Dundrum Prince, Dave, has come in for Clash Duff Fund. That's the Project Stakes winner. Unfortunately, misses this. This is Dundrum Prince, trained by Kevin Losty. He's had a pretty fair evening, it has to be said. This greyhound, I think, it is up against it on all-known form. He's got 9 races, just the 1 win. But we know the kennel's flying. Of course, Bin's Image landing the Hobbs nap, I mentioned again. In the previous race.
Just for a change. OK, let's check out the betting then, shall we? He's been plenty of action all night in that betting ring. And in there somewhere is Darrell Williams.
Dave, thanks very much. Still as busy as ever, of course, down here. Chantabar, the one they wanted. There was a bit of 6-4 early, but it's 5-4 generally, and that is still available along the boards here. 3-1 trap for 4 Droopers Route. 3-1 about 5 Drums to College, although they're just easing in a couple of places. You can get 7-2 if you look around. 5-1 trap, 1 Bullet Spiel. 8-1 is 2 Candy Kiss. And trap 6 had the bookmakers in a quandary earlier, but they've settled on 8-1 in from 10s now for Dundrum Prince.
Quick look at the Sky Sports predictor. We're already starting to load up the traps here. Trap 4 runner Dupree's Rude is top on Peter Meldrum's figures over the 5 and the 3, followed by trap 1. They are loading up already. A very long hair they have here at Shelbourne Park. It's almost 3/4 of a circuit they run the hair here. So they load up pretty quickly. What comes coming forward? Here's Errol.
Yeah, the last one going in then for this Paddy Power 525. We're back over 480 metres, basically. The hare on the move. Just looking at the boards in front of me, I can see that quite a change in the prices here. It's basically about 5-4 at the moment. Chantabar in trap 3 as the favourite, but I know there's a board next to it. It's going even money. Anyway, here comes the hare. And they're off and running up towards the first bend. Stumbling badly was Dundrum Prince in trap 6. They go into the first turn and one goes on. Bullet's Bill, that's the leader here from 2. In second place, Candy Kisses. After these comes 4, Droopy's Rude racing into third. And Drumsna College making some improvement on the wide outside. Chantabar took a bump at the first bend and is relying in fifth place. When they come around the third bend, it's Bullet's Bill leading here. Bullet's Bill out in front, leading from Drumsna College, racing up towards winner line. It's Bullet's Bill powering home, made most. Trap 1, Bullet's Bill beats 5, Drumsna College back in third, Droopy's Rude. So it has to be said, it's probably another result for the bookmakers as Bullet's Bill goes on to win here for trainer Pat Bugley and owned by Anne Hickley. It's out of Annie's Bullet, who was a fantastic bitch, of course, on our shores. As you can see, trapped out brilliantly did Bullet's Bill, showed really good early pace, but trouble for trap 3, Chantabar. The favourite got roughed up at the first bend, couldn't clear trap 2. Candy Kisses at the bend. And trap 1, Bullet's Bill was out clear. Race on for the places, basically, as they go around the third bend. You can see Drumsna College was the greyhound that came out of the pack. A youngster by Stapler's Joe started the chase hard inside the closing stages, but never going to catch up with Bullet's Bill, who looked really impressive here and has been returned at 5-1. So running at 5-1 here. Second place going to Drumsna College. And back in third, Droopy's Rude. There's the other angle as we watch them cross the line, and Bullet's Bill making most of the running this son has split the bill. 16th start, winning for the fourth time. The spotlight camera was on Chantabar. Let's find out what happened. Didn't come away brilliantly, but found itself squashed at that first bend. Got no racing room whatsoever, and it was just a rough justice, I suppose, if you back the favourite around those first two bends. But Chantabar trying to make up some progress down the far side. You can see it's moving up on the outside of trap 4, Droopy's Rude, but then seemed to falter again going around this bend. Just checked slightly at that point, but can never really figure in this contest.
Will climate control later on then come to the rescue of punters here? Bullet's Bill, another one probably filling up the bookmaker's satchels here, round about... Well, he's a 5-1 return price, I suppose, but not a lot of support, I wouldn't have thought, from him in the betting ring as well. Let's continue our build-up then to tonight's big final, shall we? Coming up in round about half an hour's time, the Paddy Power Irish Double. Hobbsy has been to see one of the contenders.
It's one of the most famous names in greyhound racing. It's the new park stud at Cleryhand, just a few miles down the road from Clonmel in County Tipperary. It's home of Sean and Anne Burke and their world-famous breeding operations. Some of the greatest sires in greyhound racing are here, the likes of Spiral Nikita, the likes of Smooth Rumble, and Ranoki. Ranoki's daughter, of course, is Mustang Mega, and she runs for Sean and Anne's son, Stephen Burke, in the Irish Derby Final. Stephen, you've had some year. Mustang Mega, of course, has had some year. But where did it all begin? How did you come by her?
It began, Jonathan, I got Mustang Mega from a friend of mine in Scotland called Alec McKenzie. he breeds a lot of dogs over there, and he sent her over to me and said that she was a nice bitch. That's all he said. I don't think he realised back then how good she was. And I took her in, and her first run, she was just, I mean, my father said afterwards that she'd probably win the Oaks. He wasn't too far off, but unfortunately not. And then she just went from strength to strength, and she just got better and better, you know.
There was a little bit of a gamble, wasn't there, that first race?
There was a little bit of a gamble. It was actually against a dog that Seamus Graham was training, and she got away, led him about three lengths down the back, and he cruised right up to her as if he was going to fly by her, but didn't go by, and she kicked on again, as she's done so many times since, and she won by about a half a length. So it was a good gambling race. There was a couple of dogs bet or whatever, and luckily enough, we came out on top.
Now, she's proved a very, very good competition bitch. I mean, if you go back to Thurley's and the champion bitch stake, which she won, and then that race against Borna Pilot, I think from that point on, you must have thought you got something special again.
Yeah, I mean, that night, I mean, Borna Pilot actually led her out, led her to the corner, and she slipped on the rail at the second bend, and they were neck and neck at the third bend. He pulled away and beat her three lengths in the track record or whatever. So, I mean, it looked at that time that, like, I mean, she was able to hang with the big boys anyway.
A pretty decent run, remembering that Borna Pilot had got away to an absolute flyer, which we know how fast he is when he can do that.
Yeah, I expected him to open up on her, and he didn't. And, I mean, her time that night was 28.75 after being beaten. So, I mean, her record the previous month or whatever was 28.68. So it was a good run for her because she'd been off for a month beforehand.
Yeah. So you took her to Harold's Cross for the Egan Catering Oaks.
Well, we actually went to Cork first, and she was second in the Cork Oaks to Happy Moments. And she was Happy Moments running real well that night and beat her on merit, but it was an excellent race. And from there we went to Harold's Cross, and Axel Grease, I think, beat her the first night. And after that, then she went from strength to strength. And actually, I was coming back from England, from the English Derby, and the final was the hare faltered or whatever, and we had to have a rerun. I was coming back from England, and I was told she'd won by the people in Kilkenny who were at the track and the intertrack, but then they didn't realise there was no hare. So as it turned out, we had to go back again the following week, and she won the following week in the fastest time of the year, 28.60.
Then, of course, across to Shelbourne Park for the Sporting Press Oaks, and again, phenomenal early pace, and almost won that one.
Yeah, she went pretty close. I mean, it was a super Oaks. I mean, 1 yard, Axel Grease and herself probably were the three pick of them, but there really was very little between them, and Axel Grease was on fire at the time. And she just was breaking quicker than us and just doing the important things right. And we were just a little bit off it, you know. But I think with a little bit of luck in the final, she might have got there, but you know what I mean. Fair juice to the winner, she ran a cracker in the night.
Now, her performances in the Derby, again, lightning early pace, such terrific trapping ability, of course. Is there one particular race that stands out for you up to the final, of course?
Probably the semi-final. Even though she got beaten, I mean, you know, she was really up against it. She was up against it in the betting, and to lead Droopy's Agassi and dogs of that quality on such a big stage and really put herself in with a real shout in the final, that was probably the biggest run for her. You know, in the quarterfinal, she was pretty impressive as well, but she had a little bit of trouble behind her and she was allowed to do her own thing. So hopefully Saturday night will stand out as well.
And the draw in trap four, I just feel that she traps better when she's got a wider draw.
Yeah, I've just had been looking at her sections on the computer and they suggest that as well. I mean, from one and two, there's probably a difference of a length. So she generally has a touch of a track leg, so she likes to be able to get a bit of an angle at the corner. So once she can get to the bend and swing the bend, as opposed to getting too close to the rail, that's the key for her. If she gets too close to the rail, she'll probably struggle to win. But if she gets fluent around the bend, well, then she's got a big chance maybe.
Now, I read somewhere that to date, of course, most memorable moment in greyhound racing was your father's success in the Irish Derby Final, of course, with Cool Performance a couple of years ago.
Yeah. I mean, that was a fairy tale. I mean,
you paraded the dog, of course.
Yeah, I paraded the dog. He was a dog that had a lot of problems early on in his career and didn't look like he was going to make it back and was written off and actually was a stud and got no bitches whatsoever. So that's the main reason we got him back, and it just went from strength to strength. And eventually we won the Derby by a short head. Against all the odds, so
against the Late Late Show, of course.
Against the Late Late Show and another super dog. It was a really good final that year. Droopy's Vieri and Droopy's Q, who also was a final on Saturday night. So, it was a fairy tale and a dream come true. And I mean, to repeat it is probably unthinkable. But we definitely wouldn't expect to do it. But very hopeful that we might be able to.
So for a first season trainer, as you say, it's almost a dream come true just to have a finalist.
Yeah, without a doubt. I mean, it's, you know, people dream of it forever with Greyhounds, and it's a privilege to be here. And, you know, if I could win it, I just take it as it comes, and you know what I mean? Certainly be trying our best, and if it happens, it happens. But if it doesn't, I wish the winner all the best and well done to them.
I've been for a good run, Mustang Mega, then later on in the final. It's a lovely setup he's got there, isn't it?
Fantastic, of course, the new park stud. I mean, principally, it is a breeding operation. Some of the greatest sires are there, of course, but training is still a massive part of it. And Stephen done terrifically well. You know, he's the only greyhound trainer I know who's got a degree in psychology. So, fascinating, good young guy, loves the game and enthusiastic. And the bitch, I mean, look at that Oak performance. Axel Grease is some bitch. And I thought, you know, Mustang Mega was unlucky not to win the Oaks, really. The longer run, of course, the 550 yards, is helping her utilise her early pace. So the 25 metres difference, she can get to the first bend. She's a massive player.
It's led up the winner, of course. Cool performance. Hopefully, might be the trainer winner.
Well, that's right. I mean, it would be a fabulous story. I mean, I thought that in itself was a fairy tale win, denying another fairy tale in late, late show. But it could be an incredible family double.
Bullets Bill won our last race in very good style, powered down the home straight to take the race in comfortable fashion by three or four lengths or so from trap five in the end. We need to confirm the SPs. Errol's got all the details.
And the full result then on the Paddy Power 5-2-5, a win for trap one. Bullets Bill returned at 5-1. Second place trap five, Drumsna College at 3-1. The winning time 28.74 suggests the track normal here at Shelbourne Park. Let's take a look at the Sky Flyer. More damage if you've backed the Sky Flyer and you've had those winners so far, you'll be jumping up and down. But already we're up to £7,560 running onto the next leg, the 9.26.
We're on now then to the Consolation Derby Final. €5,000 to the winner here. Excellent field, Droopy's Agassi. There's no doubt start one of the market leaders as well. We'll join the grounds in the parade shortly. The one dog here, Hobbs, will be told it's pronounced Shinner Wilberti.
Well, that sounds pretty decent to me. I have to say, Stephen Burke and both Ian Fortune were trying to help me with the pronunciation. Shinner Wilberti will suffice, I think. 28.67 Greyhound at Cork, of course. A quarter finalist in the Greyhound Derby, and I thought ran terrifically well at Cork last time, beating Confident Choice. Came from off the pace. Such a strong running Greyhound. But he's in trap one. He ran wide down the home straight at Cork last time.
16 of ones, it's price though, Shinner Wilberti. They're going to be a mouthful for Errol when he calls it during the race. Two is Canute, trained by Don Donoghue, currently on the boards at 4-1 here. Goes up pretty fast, and he gets a trip as well.
Oh, of course he does. I mean, he's a runner-up in the Cesarewitch, behind Droopy's Gloria, a quarter-finalist in the Derby as well, and as a greyhound who's come back from a very serious injury. It was looking a pretty bad year for John Donoghue when he lost Heavenly Hero, and then he saw Canute in Business Success injured in the early part of the year, and it'd be great if he could land the consolation with Canute. A brother of Louis Sahar, of course, who we know well.
Canute is at 4-1 in trap three. His price is Rebel. Now, reported to be his final race tonight. It could go on a winning note, big price.
I'm sure I've read somewhere that he's competed in six derbies, Prices Rebel. Fantastic servant for owner Paul Hennessy, sorry, trainer Paul Hennessy, and owners Kathleen Murphy and Brian Murphy, of course. The Scottish Derby champion of last year. He was runner-up this year in the Champion Stakes as well, behind that shot winner, World Class. And I think he's still got the track record here for the 5-2-5. 28-27, rocket.
Here's the four, Droopy's Agassi, one of the top greyhounds in the country, without a doubt. Went totally through the Greyhound Derby until the semi-finals without seeing another dog. Just had a total mishap that night.
Well, you talk about fast greyhounds and greyhounds who serve the connections well. What about Droopy's Agassi? Last year was a finalist in the Irish Derby, of course, as well as the Produce Stakes as well. This year, runner-up in the Tote Gold Cup behind Cloverhair, reached the Derby semi-finals and was a massive player, really, for outright honours. It's been a pretty decent year, you'd have to say, for the family. Top honcho, Droopy's Cheryl. He's a little mate of our English Derby champion, Droopy Stewart.
Another Paul Hennessy trained runner here is Jewel Nikita. Now, this fella's got to really come out on top to the start to have a chance.
Well, another one who reached the quarterfinals. This one, 28.36, winner at Cork. He's got a 28.76 here over the shorter trip, 5-2-5. Went out in the quarterfinals behind Droopy's Agassi, but prior to that had shown
terrific early pace and pretty decent times as well, to beat the likes of Gold Member and Droopy's Oasis, two British, former British trained greyhounds we know well.
As well as Droopy's Oasis, Owen McKenna's got Chestnut Jed in trap six in this contest as well. He really takes off in the back straight, this fellow.
He does. Semi-finalist in the Derby. Very, very strong. Down the far side, you'll see him make his move. He's the second of Owen McKenna's greyhounds, of course, and certainly second string. Went out to 20, odds of 20 to 1 in the semis behind Climate Control, and was, of course, in that race which Bookie Burglar won, where there was absolute carnage at the first bend. Was beaten a distance, but finished third and qualified.
There's the six runners then for the Derby consolation. Here's the betting from Darrell.
And Dave, Droopy's Agassi is favourite. 4-5 was available for a good couple of minutes, but it's 4-6 now, looking down the line of bookmakers here. So 4-6, trap four, Droopy's Agassi. 4-1, trap two, Canuti. There's been bits of 9-2, but nothing too serious. 7-1, trap five, Jewel Nikita. 7-1 is six, Chestnut Jet. 10-1, three, Priceless Rebel. And 16's trap one, Shinneville Bertie, which I'm told means that's it, Bertie.
Sky Sports predictor. Not that far in front, Droopy's Agassi, of the five-dog Jewel Nikita. They're both similar styles runner. Let's have a quick look at Droopy's Agassi in the quarterfinals of the Derby.
The favourite, Droopy's Agassi, he's going from five. Hair behind traps and away to go, and he's out to a flyer. Droopy's Agassi off to a flying start. Going up from three, Maryville Rumble, and four, Jewel Nikita. Into the corner, five, Droopy's Agassi. Drifts a bit wide, but leads by 2.5, 3 lengths into the back. From three, Maryville Rumble in second. Four, Jewel Nikita, making ground on the outside. Droopy's Joel putting in a big run as well, number two. A six Gold Member arrives with a rush into the third bend. But out front, it's still Droopy's Agassi, but they're getting closer. Maryville Rumble is second. Droopy's Joel is putting in a big run in behind. But up to the line is Droopy's Agassi from Droopy's Joel. A Droopy's 1-2, and Droopy's Agassi wins it for owner David Miles.
The last set, when last one's gone in, last look at the betting. Droopy's Agassi at 4-6. Hairs on the move. Here's Errol.
Early pace to Droopy's Agassi is what we're expecting. Jewel Nikita, a greyhound that might be in for a rough ride, because Droopy's Agassi can run a little bit wide, as we witnessed at Wimbledon during our derby, of course. Here comes the hare for the Paddy Power Consolation Derby Final. And they're off and running up towards the first bend. Good start from Droopy's Agassi, along with five, Jewel Nikita. And Jewel Nikita dueling for the lead. Gets slightly crowded around the bend as Droopy's Agassi went out wide. Moving up on the inside was Priceless Rebel. As they head down the far side, Droopy's Agassi leading here from Priceless Rebel. Then comes Jewel Nikita, and then comes Chestnut Jet. They come around the third bend, and it's Droopy's Agassi leading by a length here from three, Priceless Rebel, who's closing and getting up on the inside. And Priceless Rebel now goes on, racing up towards winner line at three, Priceless Rebel, by a length and a half, goes on to win. A very tight photo for second between four, Droopy's Agassi, and six, Chestnut Jet. And it's a photo second, but in the end, success two, trap three, Priceless Rebel. And what a servant he's been for trainer Paul Hennessy, as Jonathan Hobbs pointed out before. He's been, of course, a winner of a Scottish Derby. That's what we know him best for, but he's running some cracking races as well. Here we go, let's take a look at the action from the start. I did point out that Droopy's Agassi could be the thorn in Jewel Nikita, because it keeps out wide at the turns, Droopy's Agassi. Here he goes off wide again, carries out Jewel Nikita at the turn, heading down the far side. The early pace of Droopy's Agassi starting to tell here, went 2.5 lengths clear at the halfway stage. But Priceless Rebel, plenty of racing room for Paul Hennessy's runner, nipping through on the inside around the third and fourth turns to take up the lead. Scrap on in the end for second. You see that six, Chestnut Jet, is doing all its best work in the latter half. Jewel Nikita, after being crowded, dropped away. Shinneville Bertie also making a bit of progress inside the closing stages. But in the end, success here to trap three, Priceless Rebel, returned at a massive 10-1. So another surprise, another one for the bookmakers. But the old stager, Priceless Rebel, getting up inside the closing stages here off that final bend to go on and win. Scrap on for the minor placings. And I can tell you that trap six has got second, Chestnut Jet. We're back in third, trap four, Droopy's Agassi. The winning time, by the way, 29.78.
Punters who thought they might get out of trouble for the night on Droopy's Agassi had every chance down the back straight, but Priceless Rebel has charged over the last two bends and has come home to score at 10-1 in the Derby consolation final. The big final, though, is coming up pretty shortly. The favourite, Climate Control, has been in that position since the competition started. No odds on favourite, who has won the Derby for 30 years. Is Climate Control going to break the mould?
Climate Control in front. Olden Times is now challenging and coming onto the last bend. Climate Control in front. Olden Times in second. Coming up the straight is number five. Climate Control is going to win the consolation.
Welcome back then to Shelbourne Park. We're getting closer to tonight's big race. The consolation went in fine style to Priceless Rebel, who picked up Droopy's Agassi off the home bend and went on to power clear. We talked to Vinnie Jones early on. He's done the honours presenting the trophy tonight. Gay Byrne, you can just see there, three or four from the left. Former presenter of the Late Late Show over here on RTE. SPZO from Errol.
Yes, the full result at Shelbourne Park in the 9.26, the Paddy Power Consolation Derby Final, over 550 yards, of course. A win for Trap 3, Priceless Rebel, returned at 10-1. Second place, Trap 6, Chestnut Jet, at 7-1. The winning time, 29.78. And the Sky Flyer is just going to go off the boards, isn't it? You know it is. 10-1, it's now up to £83,160 to a £1 stake. If there's anyone running up onto the final, the Paddy Power, of course, Irish Derby final, good luck, because you might need it.
83 grand running on to the last leg of the fly. If you've had those five winners, or some of them, here's how they got home.
She leaves now, being chased by Droopy's Beckham in second, dropping away is Belinda Babs. Call the Police, the favourite, struggling back in fifth. They go around the second last bend, and it's Kaylin's Charm out in front. There was money on the track. There's been money in the offices this morning, and Kaylin's Charm's going to make most here. Trap 3, Kaylin's Charm, the winner. They go around the third bend. It's Spinner's Choice out in front, leading here by two lengths over two. Smooth Midas is trying to close and making some impression. One's up and down the spot. Two goes on. Smooth Midas wins, staying on for second, Prime Man. And back in third was Spinner's Choice, as they head down the far side towards the final flight there. And it's six. Connery Express leading from Cornish Cruisers, trying to pick it up. Bookie Burglar's now racing, but a long, long way behind the whole host of runners. And it's six. Connery Express still with a length lead. Cornish Cruisers closing all the time. And it's Connery Express who wins it. Trap six, Connery Express causes another major shock here. It's Tom's Mixture out in front and leading here by three lengths now. Some impression from Bin's Image. Only a length and a half between them. Tina's Girls also trying to stay on. They come around the final bend. Tom's Mixture taken on the near side four. Bin's Image is getting up and going away. Bin's Image wins, running on late for second, Tina's Girl. And fading back in third, Tom's Mixture. Shantabar took a bump at the first bend and is relying in fifth place. But as they come around the third bend, it's Bullets Bill leading here. Bullets Bill out in front, leading from Drumsna College, racing up towards Winner Line. It's Bullets Bill powering home, made most. Trump won. Bullets Bill beats five. Drumsna College back in third. Droopy's Rude. They come around the third bend, and it's Droopy's Agassi leading by a length here from three. Priceless Rebel, who's closing and getting up on the inside. And Priceless Rebel now goes on, racing up towards Winner Line. It's three. Priceless Rebel by a length and a half goes on to win. A very tight photo for second between four, Droopy's Agassi, and six, Chestnut Jet.
Confirmation of those previous six winners. Kayleen's Charm took her opening race at 7-2. One or two surprises. Connery Express, the biggest of those, at 20. Bin's Image, Bullets Bill. And we've just seen Priceless Rebel win the consolation at 10-1. We're pleased today we're joined by his trainer, Paul Hennessy. Great performance for you, Paul. Is it definitely his last race?
What is, yes. No doubt. I mean, we said it before the race even, that this was it. He knows Shelbourne Park really well. There was no point in even contemplating bringing him for the laurels or somewhere else, because, you know, he's been there, done that. Brian Murphy and Kathleen, his owners, said at the start of this year we'd run him maybe in three, four big competitions, and we tried the Scottish Derby, but we weren't lucky enough or weren't ready enough, one or the other. He went out. He finished third in the Tote Gold Cup, second in the Champions Stakes, and he's won the consolation of the Derby, and we are actually over the moon.
He's been a cracking dog for you, wasn't he, really?
Dogs like him are so rare. They're like, you know, grandmother's teeth or whatever you like.
I'm sure I read somewhere he's run in six derbies.
He's run in six derbies. Yeah, he was incredible. In the Puppy Derby, he was just touched off by Rutland Budgie. A Scottish Derby, he won. He ran in two Scottish Derbies, an English Derby, where he tripped him up on us. That's his second Irish Derby. And it's just fantastic because, you know, at home he's on a level with the Late Late Show. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? These older dogs, they're fabulous. And just to see him do that, as you know what I mean, it's the crowning moment of our year easily.
And you were kicking yourself about the semi-finals, you feel?
Yeah, we kept them on the lead going into the semis and we shouldn't have. And I mean, it's all right to talk now, it worked out great. But I mean, if you saw the dog, you know, he's on the road a long time, he's on the go a long time. And he's not the soundest dog in the world, but he's a heart and a half. And after keeping him easy, we thought, he ran so well in the quarterfinals. Mm-hmm. We thought that that'd carry into the semis, but he blew up in the semis. Mm-hmm. So we said, right, the hell with it now. We just worked away with him for the week. We gave him three bits of work, flew through them all, and there you go.
And the Late Late Show, Black and Amber Racing, £400,000 bid, I think it was. Or,
yeah, 400 sterling as well.
Yeah. Is he going down to Australia?
No, I don't think so, because, Pat and Catty Kenny, obviously, not really for me to say, but we kind of advised him. And, well, he's a national hero over here, and he's a treasure, and... like, I mean, half of us going on here is probably some, well, at least some of it is down to what he has done. And, you know, you don't send those kind of dogs.
Good.
Well fantastic. Done, Paul.
Thank you very much.
Thanks very much. Thank you. Result of competition now, one of these highlights of the programme. It's just a reminder of the question we asked you earlier on, which river runs through the fair city of Dublin, Clyde, Severn or Liffey? The answer, of course, is C, the Liffey. And tonight's lucky winner with a free £500 bet on the derby is Lee Byrne from Chatham in Kent. And he wants his monkey on the two-dog Droopy's Joel. Good luck to you there, Lee. And Droopy's Joel was a winner of the semi-finals, which we're going to take a look at that now. And this is how they got to tonight's final.
The hare's just behind the traps and away to go, and Agassiz out to a flyer. So is number three, Mustang Mega, and she leads up, and Agassiz in trouble. It's Mustang Mega leads to the bend from one, Droopy's Joel. He bumps number five, Bucky Burglar, and now into the far side is three, Mustang Mega. From one, Droopy's Joel in second and challenging. Number five, Bucky Burglar is third, and then comes number four, La Fontaine. Onto the final bend, and Droopy's Agassiz is surely out of it at this stage. Out front, it's number three, Mustang Mega. Here comes Droopy's Joel with his challenge. In third is number five, Bucky Burglar. Off the final bend into the line, and one is challenging, and Droopy's Joel gets up short of the line to win it from Mustang Mega, with four, La Fontaine getting through in third, and the favourites are out. The hare comes up behind traps, ready for off and away to go, and Climate Control is off to a flyer. So is three, King's Cadet, racing to the corner. It's three, King's Cadet, from six, Climate Control in second. Number two, oh, there's a bump there, and number three drops right out of it injured, and now it's number two, First Charter, being passed by six, Climate Control. Born a Pilot has a lot of ground to make up. He's going past Chestnut Jet. In third place is Maryville Rumble at this stage. Off the final bend, and Born a Pilot checks there. Out front, it's Climate Control up front, from two, First Charter in second. Five, Maryville Rumble is next, coming to the line. Climate Control takes it. It's close for second between First Charter and Maryville Rumble. The time is 29.80.
That's how the runners got to tonight's final. You can see Mary McLeese there, the Irish president, just working her way through the crowd here, down in the betting ring, talking to everybody. She's passing through on way to the centre of the track, where she'll make the presentation to the winner after this race. A great sight to see the president of Ireland actually here at Greyhound Racing as well. We've been joined here, Johnny Hobbs and I, by Paddy Power, from the Paddy Power Company, of course, who's sponsoring tonight's big final. You've got a cracking race, Paddy.
Oh, it's brilliant. It's turned out really good for us. I mean, it should be like this, though. I suppose the richest race in the world, 150 grand to the winner. You don't see that every day in a greyhound race. But we've been very lucky with what's got through. We've got Climate Control, serious quality in the race. So it's going to be a very short price favourite, and he's our only loser in the book. So we're sitting quite pretty with our anti-post book. We just need him to get touched off at the end, and we'd be happy.
Last time we spoke to you a couple of years ago, you know, you kept putting the prize money up. Is that the intention to put it up again next year? I mean, you know, is there a bit of rivalry between you and William Hills or not?
Well, not really. We like the ring of the Paddy Power Derby being the richest in the world, and we try and keep it that way. The 150 is a nice round number, though.
It's only just the richest in the world, in a sense. We were talking about this earlier on, but there's a deduction to be made from the €150,000, whereas the English Derby, the winner gets the actual cheque.
Well, you shouldn't be bringing up technicalities like that.
I think you're being pedantic, Mr. Smyth. That's 10% of the breeder. Come on.
Yeah. OK, let's get some betting news, shall we, from Darrell.
Dave, well, furious activity here around this favourite at Climate Control. They went up even money, all the bookmakers. Ted Hegarty tells me he's laid it to millions, and I'll take his word for it because they got stuck in their numbers. But it is 4-5 now, the favourite again, Climate Control. 3-1 trap 2, Droopers Jewel. Behind that, 9-2 trap 4, Mustang Mega. 8-6, Maryville Rumble in from 10s. 33-1 trap 1, Lafontaine. 50s trap 3, First Charge. As you can hear, it is very quiet down here. Not.
All that noise for the president, Mary McAleese. There's the Sky Sports predictor then for our last race. Trap 2 comes out best here. Droopy's Joel over the four-dog Mustang Mega. OK, Greyhounds on parade then for the big one of the night. We'll give a look through the runners in closer detail. Here's the red dog, one La Fontaine, trained by Andy Arnoux. Of course, Andy's trained the English Derby winner with Droopy's Hewitt, subject to the stewards' inquiry. 33-1 chance, Hobbsy.
Well, he's certainly a bigger price than Droopy Stewart was at Wynwood. He hasn't run one around La Fontaine, but he's done it well. He's stayed on extremely well in his races. Would you believe he's a son of Bunny's Joy, who used to run at Wimbledon low grade for Arthur Hitch, and has really come back well from a tendon injury in the back of the wrist in the early part of the year. In fact, he was off the track from May to Derby. He's trained by Andy, of course, for Larry O'Rourke in England. And, well, he's got the draw, the safe haven of the rails, to play a part.
Trap 2 runner, Droopy's Joel, Fraser Black. We've just missed that one, so we'll talk about Droopy's Joel, though. Fraser Black in Trap 2. Chances, Paddy?
We think this fella's a lay. We went biggest price about him. It's 7-2. He's just driven out of 7-2 now. Yeah. I think he's drawn to get more traffic problems than you get in the M50 on a Friday evening. So I think he could struggle around here. Needs to ping the lids. And if he pings the lids, it's a big chance. But I just don't think he will tonight.
Trap 4, Mustang Mega, Stephen Rourke's got plenty of early dash as well. Four-dog.
Yeah. Funny enough, the four-dog is the one I think is a value in the race. It's a 9-2 shot now. There was a bit of fives around earlier on. And I think Mustang Mega gets away with the best of them. And she finished strongly as well. It's a super chance. I mean, she'll do well for the fairer sex.
In Trap 5, Climate Control, odds on favourite.
Yeah, and a huge cheer has gone up. Plenty of supporters for Climate Control, trained by Seamus Graham for Kevin Smyth and Aidan O'Regan in Dublin, the consolation derby winner last year, and tremendous performances this year as well. He won the Ted Hegarty 550, a cracking field there. He had his tonsils out in midsummer, would you believe? Dominated the derby ever since.
Trap 6, Paddy's Maryville Rumble, trained by Francie May, really powers home from the last two bends.
Well, I think Maryville might just be drawn a little bit wide tonight, but if Climate does happen to miss the break, Maryville came in from 5 at the semi-finals. It might come in from 6 tonight. It might ruin the race for Climate. And as you said, powers home, so it was definitely in with a squeak. I think 8-1 is a massive price.
Didn't get a chance to talk about the three-dog, Hobbsy, first charter, Reggie Roberts runner.
Well, Reggie, of course, had two finalists last year, didn't he? He had Droopy's Reese, of course. And you'd have to say that first charter is probably up against it. He's got a bit of early pace, but really I think he's going to have to take a flyer, I think, as Paddy said.
So what's the best book on the book for you?
Well, the only loser we have is Climate Control, so the rest of them are
so
all
it's
winners.
It's a good book all
it's
in
a,
all
it's
all
a good
really.
Book, yeah. We've got one dog, but we pretty much backed everything against Climate, so it's grand.
But what about the punt on Droopy's Joel? I mean, was that, heavy anti-post with you, or you always ducked it?
We kind of ducked him along. We were out to get him now in the final at 7-2, and we got bits and pieces of him, but we're still happy enough with the anti-post book as we stand.
Grand.
Climate Control, though, he's been all the rage ever since, really, the competition. He's always been your favourite, Climate Control. He was a lot of books.
Well, he was as big as 33 and 40s before the competition started, but coming close to the competition, he was favourite the whole way along. Yeah, we tried to keep him to ourselves. We didn't manage to do it. We kind of fancied him from the start, but still laid him.
OK, let's go to Lady Betting News. Here's Errol.
Dave, it's still 4-5. You can still have it if you want 4-5 Climate Control here. They're betting 7-2 about Trap 2, Droopy's Joel. That, again, is freely available along the line. 9-2 into 4-1, in fact, a few places now. Trap 4, Mustang Mega. Elsewhere, they're going 8-1, Trap 6, Maryville Rumble. It is then 33's Trap 1, Lafontaine, and 50's Trap 3, First Charter.
And there is the favourite, Climate Control, Seamus Graham's Greyhound. Won the consolation, of course, last year, Jonathan. It was in everybody's books, really, for this year after that.
Well, he ran up in the tote gold collar at Harold's Cross and suffered a bad injury in doing so. That was behind Cabbage White. But he came back, and I think it was Easter Cup night, Easter Cup final night. He absolutely stormed home in 28-40-odd. And ever since then, he's been most people's idea of the winner, of course. Seamus Graham has won the derby a couple of times with Dip Mack and Tina Marina. You talk about
Mustang Mega. I think four bitches in the history of the English Derby have won the English Derby. I think in Ireland we've had three in the last 13 years, Paddy, likes of Teenham Marina. We had the other toss and also Springtime.
Yeah, it's a good race for the fairer sex. So I think Mustang Mega is mine anyway for the night. That's the one I've had a few quid on.
You've got fantastic early pace. Talking about the family double, when you look at Stephen and Sean Burke, Cool Performance, with Droopy's Joel, his dad, his sire, Droopy's Cool, was in the Cool Performances Derby 2 years ago.
Okay, good luck, everybody, then, with your bets in this year's running of the Paddy Power Derby Final, called by Errol Blythe.
Yes, the last couple going in. Maryville Rumble nearest to us going into the traps. When I arrived at the track around 5:30, I walked up to Ted Hegarty. I said, how's business? Because they'd been already been betting. And he said, I've already laid a 10,001 Maryville Rumble. Straight away, listen to the roar then for the Paddy Power Irish Derby Final for 2003. €150,000 to the winner. The second gets 30,000. The third, 15,000. The unplaced finalist, £7,500 euros each, should I say. Here comes the hare, they're off, and springing out in front is three First Charter ahead of four Mustang Mega as they go into the bend. Five Climate Control showing the pace round and is about to take up the lead off the second bend. It's Climate Control going on from First Charter in second. After these comes Mustang Mega. A gap back to six Maryville Rumble, then comes one La Fontaine. They've reached the second last bend and it's Climate Control, the favourites, leading here by a good 2.5 lengths over Mustang Mega. She's brave in second, she's trying to cut into the lead. Climate Control leading and wins the Paddy Power Irish Derby for 2003. Mustang Mega, a brave effort back in second. I'll tell you the third a little bit later on, but high excitement here as the favourite does the business in the end for Seamus Graham, owned by Mr. Kevin Smyth and Aidan O'Regan. It powered down the far side, so much middle pace from this greyhound. It did trap out brilliantly Climate Control. Mustang Mega came away, so did First Charter. That was a big shocker. You could see the two dogs on the inside, La Fontaine and Troopies Joel, find a bit of trouble there at the first bend. But keeping out middle to wide was Climate Control, quickening away down the far side. Mustang Mega, who ran on so well, tap for toe down the far side. But she comes again, though, coming home. She's won a brave race back in second. But boy, Climate Control, such a fast dog for Seamus Graham. Showed so much speed last year, of course, looked unlucky in the competition last year when knocked out at the quarter-final stage, running very wide off the final bend, but lasting home, Mustang Mega, keeping on best of the rest for second. Six Maryville Rumble back in third, and then after these, you can see, moving up in the fourth place, looked to be La Fontaine, just ahead of First Charter, and Troopies Joel, I have to say, a little bit disappointing after taking a first bend bump, but in the end, success to Climate Control. And what a win, what a classy greyhound. He's clocked some real fast times around here at Shelbourne Park, and he goes on to take the Paddy Power Irish Derby for 2003. Climate Control, of course, has been in fine form during the course of the Derby, just one defeat during the Derby behind King's Cadet, but has run a corker in the final. We knew it had the early pace, it doesn't trap. For some reason, it just doesn't seem to come away here at Shelbourne Park, but it's the early pace and that scintillating middle pace, back straight pace down the far side, goes on to win and win well.
What a performance then by Climate Control to present here. Mary Magalese waiting for the Greyhound and the Connections to come back to present them with the trophy here for the Paddy Power Irish Derby. Didn't break in front, Climate, but he showed some track carpet at the first bend.
What a quite outstanding Irish Derby Final. Paddy Power Irish Derby Final. Tremendous. A tremendous winner in Climate Control. But when 3, 4 and 5 went to the bend, you thought that something had to give, but it didn't. They went round. Tremendous start from First Charter in trap 3. And the bitch, the sole bitch in the race, she could have been squeezed out there. She could have checked up. A lesser bitch would have done. But she didn't. She kept her line. It allowed trap 5, that we know he's got terrific pace from bend 2 to 3. And the Irish Derby champion has gone clear. And the cheer that went up was absolutely deafening. I have to say that Mustang Mega's run an absolute superb race in second. I saw Stephen walk past Stephen Burke, he fist up because he knew that he'd got second place. I think that was certainly consolation for the performance of his bitch. But Climate Control, a third Irish Derby victory for Seamus Graham. And plenty of support anti-post as well. I mean, he's been to the fore in the anti-post market right from the very start. And I said earlier, the likes of Serene Rumble, the likes of Droopy's Agassi, the likes of Born of Pilot all fell by the wayside, but Climate Control, he bounced back from an injury at the turn on the back end of last year. He even had a problem with his tonsils in midsummer as well. They rectified that. And a fantastic night for Kevin Smyth and Aidan O'Brien there. It's a local victory. They're both based in Dublin. Of course, Seamus Graham in Leith.
Just clock to 29.71. Just watching a replay again there. Four, got a slight touch from three between the last two bends. And might just have checked his ride a little bit.
Well, I think Reggie Roberts can be absolutely proud of his Greyhound first charter, who, you know, terrific trapping ability and certainly went for gold right from the very, very start. It's been called 5-4-6. Maryville Rumble stayed on for third for David Cahill and Francie Murray. But it's all about Climate Control. And as he launched himself to the front off the second bend, I tell you, the roar was frightening, fantastic.
And in the winners' area here, I mean, it's a bit like the Cheltenham Festival when the Irish have a winner. There is must be 100 people around the presentation podium here where the Greyhound's about to be produced as well. And there's the trainer just in the grey suit there, Seamus Graham, just coming through to enormous cheers as well from everybody here as well. Winning the Grand Derby, of course, is just a pinnacle, isn't it, of a trainer's career?
Well, Seamus, of course, knows all about it. He trained the bitch Tina Marina. He also trained Dip Mac, of course, as well. And last year they went pretty close, didn't they? They won the Derby Consolation, the event that Priceless Rebel has just won. So even at that stage, well, as a young greyhound, he ran tremendously well. September 2000, just turned 3 years of age. He's at the peak of his powers, and he's claimed the €150,000 prize.
In all the excitement, we better check out the SBs and Flyer from Errol.
Yes, the result then on the 9:46 here at Shelbourne Park, the Paddy Power Irish Derby for 2003, success to Trap 5, Climate Control, the turn the 4-5 favourite. Second place, Trap 4, Mustang Mega at 7-2, and third at Trap 6, Maryville Rumble. The winning time, 29.71, but it's not about the times, it's about the performance and the scintillating early and middle pace from Climate Control. Sky Flyer, let's add on Climate Control for a little bit of sense to the Sky Flyer off those outsiders that we've had this evening at Shelbourne Park. The 4-5 favourite means there's £149,688 if you had those six winners.
Climate Control did get Pundas out of trouble a little bit, returned at 4-5, a fantastic win as well. Quite sure the last time a Blue Dog won the Greyhound Derby. Colour-wise, we're talking about, not jacket-wise.
I have to say, I can't answer the question there, but sometimes Blue Dogs can be quite unfashionable with owners, trainers, breeders
funny,
even. But
when I first came in a Greyhound,
most have the huge pace.
A Blue Dog.
Well, exactly, but a lot of them have huge pace. I remember Blue Merlin, of course, over in Britain, but fantastic performance from Climate Control. And even overcoming the jinx, really, of the of being favourite. It's been a while, really.
Should we look at the race one more time?
Yeah, I think we should do.
Be great to see it again. I mean, the pace that Climate Control showed on the run to the first bend. I mean, he broke about fourth. He did get a touch from six on the outside as well. And have another look at the coming together of three and four at the second last bend. Not a lot, but he just checked his stride.
Well, three, four, and five have just gone round almost like on skates, really, haven't they? In lanes. I mean, something had to give. There's no question that Climate Control has blown them away from 2-3. The bitch has taken a knock there at the third bend, and I have to say, testament to her that she managed to claim the runner-up prize for Connections. Trap 6 for finishing with a fair rattle. And La Fontaine for Andy Iano staying on well, but that's what we know he's been doing throughout the competition. But, certainly a worthy winner. I think I was here last year with Bypass Byway. That was a track record performance, and prior to that, cool performance. You're looking for a performance worthy of the Irish Derby champion, and that was one.
That's just a part of the scrum you're looking at there. That's round the winner. Darrell's doing his best to try and weave his way into the crowd to talk to somebody, but it's very difficult as well. But we're going to be back again on Tuesday on Sky Sports with the All England Cup final, won last year by Let It Slip. Let's just a look back at what happened 12 months ago.
Everyone waiting with bated breath to see who's going to bomb out of the traps. We're expecting Sparta-Rolo to do that. It's come away well with Bomber Graham as they go up towards the first bend. Sparta-Rolo's trying to cut the bend. It's momentum. Bomber Graham, though, on its inside and let it slip on the outside. It's handy to head down the far side. It's Bomber Graham. Let it slip on his shoulder. After this comes Stuart Little. They're coming down towards the third bend. Bomber Graham with Let It Slip to worry about. Let It Slip now goes on for David Mullins and they come off the final bend. It's Trap 6. Let It Slip starting to go clear from one. Bomber Graham. Then comes three. Stuart Little. It's going to be Trap 6, Let It Slip, winning by a couple lengths in the end from one Bomber Graham, and back in third with Trap 3.
Yes, we're back on Tuesday. Hobbsy and I will be in Newcastle, providing the celebrations are finished here by then for the William Hill All England Cup. We're on Sky Sports 3 at 7:30. We're on air as well. Darren's got a quick weather connections.
Dave, Seamus Graham, if you'd just be kind enough just to spin around 2 seconds, Seamus, for us, please, for Sky Sports. This is exciting, isn't it? How's this compared to other winners?
They're all great. it's always great to win the Derby. But this dog cracked the hock at the end of last year. And I knew it was okay in January, but I told the guys behind them that they wouldn't see much of him until the back end of the year, that my main aim was to win the Derby.
He had to get out, didn't he? And he did it.
He did. He's a great dog.
How does it compare to other winners? You've won this twice before.
Well, Dipmac was the first one, and Dipmac was a brilliant dog. He could go from trap one to six. They're all the same. Tina Marina, she was 20-1 in the final. She flew out, got a bit of trouble at the first bend because she hadn't enough of early, but when she went second into the back straight, she absolutely flew.
You've made a lot of Irish punters, I think, very happy tonight, haven't you?
Yeah, I'm not a punter myself, but I know a lot of people has a lot of money on him. I told him early in the year that I thought he was a dog worth keeping.
This is something else this night, isn't it? Well done, Seamus, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Well done, Darrell, and getting an interview there with the winning trainer. And there is the winning greyhound, and there is the trophy as well. Well, just about to be presented by Mary McAleese. Climate controller, fantastic night's greyhound racing here. I suppose the plan now will be to retire him.
I should imagine a lucrative stud career pretty much beckons for climate control.
Well, it's been a great night. Thanks for
fantastic,
your company.
Fantastic, yeah.
We'll enjoy do it all again on
right
Tuesday.
From the start. Exactly, even in the cold as well.
Yeah. Well, climate control then is the toast of all Ireland. I hope you've enjoyed the programme from Dublin tonight. We'll see you Tuesday. Bye bye.
I don't want you to give it all up and leave your own life collecting dust. And I don't want you to feel sorry for me. You never gave us a chance to be. And I don't need you to be by my side.